warning, my head is not covered, but I wanted to make this video while it was on my mind. It's about walking in the spirit, and it's not intended to be all-inclusive, but I have heard regularly from multiple people, they really don't understand what it is to walk in the spirit, or they are trying to walk in the spirit. So I just wanted to bring a little bit of quick clarity to this. Ultimately, what it is to walk in the Spirit is to die and allow the Spirit of God to live through you. Like Paul says in Galatians, I have died. I have died. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith through the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. So, when the Bible tells us not to quench the Spirit, anytime we are in control, we are walking in the flesh. Anytime you are trying to do something good, it's you doing it. It's not the Spirit doing it. You are to be an empty vessel filled with the Spirit of God, just like he compares it to wine. You can take an empty vessel and you can fill it with wine. The wine is going to control you. If you've ever been drunk or had enough wine, that it affects you in this way. The wine is now controlling what you say, what you do, where you go. All of it is, the more filled with wine you are, the more the wine controls you. You know, you're doing things that you would never do because why? You're filled with wine. Likewise, you're to be an empty vessel. This fleshly body, it has the mind of the flesh. If you are a believer, you are now filled with the Spirit of God. Well, your flesh is to be reckoned dead. You are to die. And as you die, the Spirit of God then moves in and through you, and you can be used for his purposes. All those things about what it is to walk in the Spirit, you cannot manifest those. When the Spirit of God is moving in and through you, he will be manifested. And how will you know that he is being manifested? Because the evidences of the Spirit be coming through your life. The fruit of the Spirit, the evidence, manifestation that the tree is being operated by the Spirit is, you know, what? It's early. Love, joy, peace, patience, goodness, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. These are evidences that the Holy Spirit of God is moving in into your vessel to do his good purpose. You are simply to be available. You are to make your vessel available. Offer yourself as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God. Sacrifice, you're dead. Your actions are not the sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. You're death. Anytime you use the word sacrifice, it's death. So your death is holy and pleasing to God. How are you a living sacrifice? Because you're still alive in this body. So you're to reckon that flesh dead and allow the Spirit of God in you to live, which is what Paul talks about. That's our entire life in Romans 7. You have the war of the flesh against the Spirit of God. It's not the war of your flesh against your spirit. It's the war of your flesh against the Spirit of God who now lives and dwells and breathes within you. And you don't like that because it doesn't feel good. Dying sucks. And none of us want to die because we are alive in this body and it's not comfortable and it doesn't feel good. But it is your reasonable obligation to die, considering what Jesus did for us. So walking in the Spirit is something that you cannot in and of yourself produce, except that you can die, which ultimately you can't do anything unless God grants it to you. So if you want to understand this and you want to die, you need to pray and confess first that you cannot do anything God has asked you to do, and that he must live in and through you, and then you must ask him to do so, at which point you will die and he will live. When you find your flesh is resurrected, you pray, you sacrifice yourself, he lives through you. This is the life of a believer. This is the life of a spirit-filled believer. You have no control over doing holy things, doing right things, doing biblical things, doing godly things. That's not walking in the Spirit. That's you doing stuff. Get out of the way. You have no idea what he wants to do in and through you. You're ways are not his ways, your thoughts are not his thoughts, and you have no idea what's going on in anybody else's mind and heart and life, but the Holy Spirit of God does. So get out of the way and let him live in and through you. That's what it is to walk in the Spirit. Good luck with that.